When it comes to weddings, everybody wants their dreams to come true. But unless you have a boundless budget, it's I do, but at what cost?
I've got a bride here who's pretty upset. When I spoke to you yesterday, give me the absolute worst scenario and we'll work it back from there.
Right? No, those are pretty cheap and hideous.
Okay.
I don't like that idea one bit.
The budget is top-notch importance here.
The stupid smoke machine just pissed all over the floor.
Weddings are thrilling. Weddings are trying. Weddings are taxing on your bank account. Meet Paul and Danielle, just married. Did they have the funds to make their wedding day a winter wonderland? Well, climb aboard their matrimonial sleigh and get ready for one wild ride.
My name is Danielle. I'm 20 years old and I work in a dental office. I've dated Paul for over 4 years. This is the story of our dream wedding day.
Weddings and money, like Danielle and Paul, stick together like metal on ice, an inseparable combination. At the end of the show, we'll let you in on what our couple spent to make their winter wedding a reality.
Down the road, I've got other plans. I don't want to have the wedding bills to be sitting over my head for a few years or anything, but it was nice and small.
As corny as it sounds, it was like a fairy tale. It was coming true.
The wedding may have seemed like a fairy tale, but Danielle, you're not Snow White, and this saga wasn't without its bad apples. Let's flip back to page one and find out what really happened.
I think I hoped that David would kind of help us lower our costs.
Yeah, I didn't think we would honestly save money, but my only expectation was that he was there to help us out and just take care of things.
Meet David Valley, wedding planner. With over 10 years' experience, could he create Danielle's snow-themed wedding on a frozen budget? Oh, it could get chilly.
I think every couple should find one thing to make their wedding unique and memorable. For example, if you're a horseback riding couple, why not come to the altar on horseback? Whoa! So here we are, and the first thing I want to ask you guys is get a sense of what kind of wedding you are going to have, like your vision, and also just sort of the style of wedding.
I envision for our wedding to be beautiful and romantic and soft and play on our winter wonderland theme.
Because it's going to be a winter wedding, yeah.
Yeah.
I am thinking a lot of candles that look like ice cubes. Are you on side with this winter wonderland theme, or?
I'd like to see some of the candles before we decide on it. It sounds like a neat idea.
I'm trying to get a sense, Paul, of how sort of involved a groom you are, because you know grooms come in all shapes and sizes these days.
No, he's definitely the decision maker.
Okay, because usually it's the bride that's sitting in that chair. That's kind of interesting.
Not in this case.
Okay.
Paul has control issues, I think, with everything when it comes to the wedding.
I think I'm very particular in what I want about the wedding, just because I want everything to go smoothly and look nice and elegant, but I still want to keep it cheap.
How many guests are you going to have?
Between 100 and 130.
Okay.
Basically, anyone who hasn't been going out with someone for a year, we've had to just say, sorry, they can't come.
1 year?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Well, have you thought about what you'd like to do with the wedding cake?
We were looking for probably the best bang for our buck, I think,
right.
On that front.
Okay.
We've seen somebody who does it in the flea market locally.
Flea market and wedding cake. These things aren't sort of gelling for
They're
me.
They're forced to be up to code, believe it or not.
Okay.
The same as a restaurant. They have food inspectors and whatnot.
They're both a bit quiet, a bit reserved. They've got a good wedding planned for their budget, but I'm hoping to find something for them that gives them that wow factor. Are you thinking about sit-down dinner, cocktail style? What's the party style going to be for the wedding?
We've thought about doing a country-style dinner.
And it's everybody sits at their table, it's brought to you, but it's almost buffet-style in the sense you take whatever you need.
Except the food's there.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that might be fun. Have you got any ideas about your flowers yet?
We don't want real flowers.
You don't want real flowers?
No.
So it's going to be all artificial stuff?
Yes.
There are some wonderful artificial products out there, and there are some stuff that looks like your great-grandmother's house.
Yeah.
You don't want the latter,
yeah.
Right? So we've got simple church wedding, gorgeous reception at the Shriners Club, Winter Wonderland, DJ, gorgeous, gorgeous, fabulous. The real big question is, what's your budget?
Well,
let's go plan a wedding.
Coming up.
So we're not talking about this, right?
No, those are pretty cheap and hideous.
that was our flowers. They were lovely. They were not extravagant. And they were very bright and cheery.
My mind was just on the girl I was married.
Oh, isn't that lovely?
When you're planning a wedding, there's no end to what a bride can spend. But at what point does I do become, I might be skating on economic thin ice?
Flea market and wedding cake. These things aren't sort of gelling for me.
At the end of the show, we'll reveal what our couple did to avoid financial frostbite on their big day.
I know David wasn't very happy about the idea of silk flowers. I think because he is a flower person, to him the idea of, you know, the dollar store cheapy look kind of was what was in his head. But I mean, I never doubted her.
So you have a family connection here, right?
Friends, yes.
So you guys know each other, and you do some silk flower arrangements sort of as a freelancer?
Right, as a hobby.
As a hobby, okay. I guess maybe, what are you looking for?
I want roses. I like cream roses because my dress is white.
Right.
I think it'd be a nice little contrast, subtle.
Having not worked with them before, I went out and I found some stuff that kind of scared me. First, bouquet. There is just nothing lifelike here. I guess this is what you do, right?
It will not look like that. That's not what I do.
Okay, so we're not talking about this, right?
No, those are pretty cheap and hideous.
Okay, well, we've got these. These even smell bad.
Something no, that's nothing like that.
So I mean, I'm a total neophyte when it comes to this stuff. I mean, what are we looking at budget-wise?
If your budget could go a little bit higher in case I can't find you a good deal, how high are you willing to go?
I think we've pretty much agreed that we max out around $250 on flowers.
Well, you've given me a challenge, but
this is what
it will
you
not
do,
look
right?
like that.
Okay.
That's not what I do.
Yeah, I want quality. Right. I don't want that.
I could do this for $7.95.
We went a little high on the flowers just because Adele found some really amazing flowers. We said, go right ahead. And they turned out great, well worth the money.
I think every bride looks forward to dress shopping, and they're supposed to.
Oh, this is beautiful.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Trying on 100 different dresses, trying to find the one is not good.
We have an extensive selection from Alfred Angelo.
What do you think of this one?
I like that. I like the sparkly.
Bridal Lane.
How about this? Lots of puff.
I like that.
Absolutely. Maggie Sotero.
That's nice.
Alfred Sung. Ooh. So we have lots to choose from. We have
Look
dresses.
Look at this, Danielle.
With color.
Since when do I wear pink?
But it's gorgeous.
Yeah. Off the rack doesn't always guarantee a good fit on the rack.
Look at the sparkle. That's different.
I'm not big on the idea of cleavage on my wedding day.
Guys will be looking at the bride in a different way.
Definitely not me.
Well, we've got
on
lots
her.
More.
I like that.
This is another look.
It's very pretty on you, Danielle.
I think this one is a definite, though.
That's a definite? Okay.
But I feel like I should be able to go, wow, this is it, you know? And I don't feel like that with any of these dresses. I just don't feel like, wow.
After going through so many dress shops and that, you kind of start feeling really fed up.
What's a modern bride to do when she can't find the dress she wants? Surf the web, of course.
I honestly wasn't informed about the online purchase until after it was done. By the time I was told it was done, it was already here.
Is that ever beautiful?
It looked great. She was fantastic, stunning.
Aw, let's hope you can have your cake and eat it too.
The cake for the wedding, I envisioned personally something big and grand, but fairly cheap.
So it's six different kinds of cake then?
Yes.
Within the one cake.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a large vanilla layer goes in, a marble layer, a chocolate layer,
right.
A banana layer, a lemon layer, and the carrot half rounds on either side.
Okay. Doing all of this for $250.
Yeah, if you're not happy with your cake, we give you 100% money back guarantee.
Wow. I've never heard anyone doing that before, although you've never had to give it back before, I take
no,
it.
No, no. All right, do you want
banana?
The banana next, okay.
Oh, that's really good.
Banana for a wedding cake? You may want to peel yourself away from that choice, Danielle.
I think we're going to go against the banana, though.
I wasn't keen on the banana either, so that's good.
Good decision. Oh, by the way, David, Cruella DeVille called and she wants her coat back.
We had decided on doing chocolate and vanilla on the cake.
He did exactly what we want for on the outside of the cake, and that's honestly what mattered to me. And that's what I got is what I wanted. I think the guest favors went over well. We bought too many just because we bought them before we had our final RSVP numbers. But yeah, everybody loved them.
Definitely.
Everyone loved them, Paul. Did you take a good look at them?
What is this?
Guest favors.
I said no candle holders.
It's not just a candle holder. We can use them as part of our centerpieces, too, if you want.
I don't like that idea one bit.
Maybe David won't think these snowmen are abominable. Yeah, right.
This is the guest favorite here.
Oh, that's cute. So this is, I'm just trying to sort of visualize it with that stuff. I don't know whether it exactly fits into the direction that we're going in with the tables. I'm also worried, I mean, you're giving one per couple kind of thing.
Yes.
Yeah, there'd be a lot of on the tables to be like a sort of village of snowmen.
Looks like David was a bit frosty about the snowman.
The decor demo that David put together at his place was just a little too much.
Beautiful glass chairs, tablecloths, expensive Italian glassware, and these beautiful ice cube candle holders.
I like the candle holders, but we've got pretty much everything else.
Right.
So let's focus on the candle holders and the centerpieces.
And the centerpieces, yeah.
How much is that going to cost?
Yeah, totally? Like say just this section.
This
right
section here.
Here.
Okay. We would have to rent these because they'd be really expensive to buy. So you're looking at probably about $30 to $40, I would imagine.
What do you think?
Yeah, we'll have to discuss that a little more.
And David and Danielle were about to duke it out.
I'm just wanting to get a sense from you as to where you see everything happening.
The archway will be where the door, where you come in.
Okay.
The cake table will be over
right.
In this corner.
Right.
All these little trees kind of go strategically throughout the place, and they have little Christmas lights. What's wrong with them?
I think they look really artificial on their own right now.
I think they're still a nice little twinkle. I like them.
The venue presents a lot of challenges in terms of the fact that there's a fair number of offending qualities to it that we either have to try to mask or somehow change.
Me and David, we kind of had a little bit of a headbutt.
Having looked at the room and talked to you and Paul, is these chairs have to go. It's the only thing visually that I think is going to really, really mar the kind of look that we've worked together creating.
I understand what you're saying, and I agree the chairs aren't pretty, but when it comes down to it, the budget is top-notch importance here.
Let me put a budget together for you on what we need to rent, and in that budget is going to be chair covers.
Yes, David, you put your foot down, but didn't the decor costs go up?
I think in the end, actually, David helped us spend a little more because he kind of sells you the idea of the grand, and he makes you really want that.
Coming up.
I've got a bride here who's pretty upset. Well, when I spoke to you yesterday, I said I was becoming between 12 and 1 o'clock. Give me the absolute worst scenario, and we'll work it back from there.
Well, I felt pretty good because I dropped into my mother's place, and she gave me about 3 big shots of whiskey. And that kind of soothed the nerves a bit, so.
No matter what your budget, when you're planning a wedding, costs can spiral out of control.
The budget is top-notch importance here.
In that budget is going to be chair covers.
At the end of the show, we'll let you in on exactly how well our couple did at keeping within their allotted amount. The dress had arrived, the centerpieces were designed, and the cake was assembled. Had they forgotten anything? Oh, yeah, for Danielle and David to put their differences on ice.
I'm not a woman of surprise. I've spent 7 months planning this wedding, and I want to make sure everything looks perfect. But wait a minute, where's the chocolate?
I really was worried about that, but that doesn't look too bad at all. Which side is chocolate and which side is vanilla?
There is no chocolate.
What?
Yeah.
You called him on Monday, and you asked specifically
for chocolate and vanilla.
Yeah. And what did he give you? I hope not banana.
No.
Good.
Vanilla and marble.
Vanilla and marble, so.
I'm slightly disappointed, but the vanilla's good, and we have a lot of people that like vanilla, and the rest of it turned out so perfect that I'm not even in the mood to complain.
Okay, okay.
I wanted to go to the hall because I expect him to have everything ready to go. Instead, he came in and we're missing this, and you know, they kind of messed up that, and that had me a little on edge.
they didn't give me the nicer candles. All I got were the smaller ones. So there was a screw up in the order.
What do you mean?
You know, these are the ones that they delivered.
I didn't even know we had those.
Yeah, those were on your table too. Those were your little ones on the table. And there's
I didn't even know we had those. Bigger ones were the only ones I
The bigger ones are the ones that are missing.
I thought when we had done it, they were all ice cube candles.
No, I had a combination of both of them.
No. They were all ice cube candles, the ones you showed us at your house.
I wouldn't have used them on the bottom because they're just too damn expensive to go on the bottom.
But those wasn't what we used to do it.
I had them on the tables.
Did you really, David? Let's take a peek. Oops, David, looks like you're skating on thin ice now.
He tried to rectify the problem, and he did. But I wasn't very happy when he handed me a phone saying, oh, talk to her. And I thought, you know what? You're the wedding planner. Just do it. Here's David.
I might even be able to get them on a truck. Yeah, I've got a bride here who's pretty upset. What time is it now?
4 almost, 1:45.
Give me the absolute worst scenario and we'll work it back from there. Just get it done, okay?
1.
What's that?
1.
I'll pick them up tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock.
So I guess tomorrow it is. Time was ticking.
Getting ready at my house was a little awkward because it's not very big and I have my own little way of getting ready. I sit behind a door and look at the mirror and everybody kept coming in and out and moms are showing up and I gotta put flowers on people and I was starting to get frustrated because it's just like, I need to get ready.
And let go of the reins, but you couldn't, could you?
Hi there, David, how's it going?
Good, we're just finishing up here, honey.
The candle holders arrived?
Yeah, I picked them up on my way through.
Okay, and they're all set up, right?
Yeah, everything's ready to go.
Okay.
You better get dressed, okay, sweetie?
I happen to be 10 after 2 right now, my love. Come on, I'm gonna help her put it on before.
Bye.
While our couple were trying to make it to the church on time, David was struggling to figure out the mechanics of the cake. No time like the present for a smoke break, especially when you're running late.
Yeah, I couldn't believe that. The girl who's always 15 minutes early shows up to the church.
I probably got there right
at 3 o'clock.
Yeah.
Coming up.
Oh, girls, no. Girls, if I stand over this way, there's water on the floor there.
I was standing there waiting, and she come down the aisle looking very beautiful with her dad. And I thought to myself that you're a very lucky person to be getting a beautiful lady like this as your wife.
You never told me that.
When it comes time to pledge eternal love, your heart may be willing, but how about your wallet? No matter what the budget, is it ever enough?
I wouldn't have used them on the bottom because they're just too damn expensive to go on the bottom.
No.
Soon, we'll reveal just how much cold, hard cash it took for Danielle and Paul to pull off their big day.
I was nervous right before I walked down the aisle, but as soon as I got out and was walking down that aisle and I seen him, the world just slowly seemed so much easier.
Hi, Paul. Take you, Danielle, to be my wife.
Hi, Danielle. Give you my hand, that we may always be side by side.
All I can do is smile and think, wow, she's gorgeous.
You ain't looking too shabby yourself there.
Aw, doesn't that just melt your heart?
My first thought when we walked into the hall was it was like a fairy tale. It was phenomenal. Everybody was ranting about how wonderful the food was.
Yeah, it was perfect.
Well, almost perfect.
I don't like the dress. I can't feel your bum.
Good. I was terrified when everybody was sitting down and they should have been dancing because the music's going and there's nothing else going on and I wanted people to be dancing.
Should I speak to the DJ? What kind of music? Should I get him to jazz it up a bit? I mean, 9:50, like the guy should be.
Yeah, start ramping it up.
Yeah, okay, good. As long as we're on the same page.
Once he started playing requests more and that, everybody started kind of getting out there a little more and I felt a lot better then.
Yes, the atmosphere was smoking, even though the machine wasn't.
The stupid smoke machine just pissed all over the floor. Oh, girls, no. Girls, if I stand over this way, there's water on the floor there.
David was, you know, stammering with the towels. And by the time I realized what he was doing, he already had it cleaned up anyway, so it didn't even affect us.
For Danielle and Paul, it was a magical winter wonderland.
It was worth it. I feel like all the stress, all the planning, all that time we spent on the wedding was definitely worth it.
But here comes the bill. Let's hope it doesn't leave them frozen in their tracks.
The budget we handed David was $12,000.
The reception was phenomenal for our venue and food and alcohol included. Our total cost was $4,474.
David was great and I couldn't have asked for anything more. His fee was $1,250.
For that once in a lifetime feeling, my dress and my accessories were all worth the $825.
Who knew that silk flowers could look so real? Only $250.
The cake was great, and even without the chocolate, it was $250.
The additional costs, including DJ, centerpieces, and guest favors, were $3,721.
And what we actually spent was $10,770.
So we were under budget by $1,230. So now we're off to the Mayan Riviera for the honeymoon.
The couple is thrilled, their budget is frozen, and their wedding a success. The only question left is, has David finally fallen for the snowman?
Oh, yes. No, that's not a problem buying the dress. And whatever the amount was, it was a lot more than he thought. He said, as long as you wear it to work every Monday.
Yeah. I don't remember the cake at all.
Don't you? We have it in the freezer.
Oh, really?
Ah, that's gonna leave a mark.